So my first impressions of it are I actually like it a lot. I like the body lines of it. I like the shape of it. The interior is very comfortable. I think Ford actually did an excellent job at creating a electric SUV. I'm gonna jump on the bandwagon with everybody else though. You're gonna get sick of hearing it, I promise. And you're definitely gonna get sick of reading it in the comments. I don't know why they called it a Mustang. It's really cool. Just a Mustang should be a V8 and it should have two doors. And Ford, I'm sorry, but that's my opinion on the name. My favorite parts about it, I like the headlights a lot. I think that they are actually Mustang-esque. It makes the front end of this thing look pretty mean. I would remove the Mustang badge altogether on the front. I think it looks out of place, even if you're gonna call it a Mustang. I just think it kind of looks weird up there. And I really enjoy the massive touchscreen in the middle, but I don't really like the way that it's set in the dash. It's just sort of floating and hanging out. It almost looks out of place, but the interface itself and the screen is beautiful. Those are my thoughts on the Mustang Mach-E.
Very fastback-ish. The headlights, obviously they're not on, but they look very Audi-ish, which I think is very cool. If it wasn't for the Mustang badge on the front though, I think it just kind of looks like a Ford Escape. Another thing I'm not sure on is if it's unlocked or not, but you just push a button to open the doors. I'm not sure how it's gonna work in the wintertime, especially back here where you can't get on there and really just start prying on it. Overall, I mean, I think it's a pretty cool car. The interior's very modern looking, almost McLaren-ish with a little dash piece there for, well, not your tach, but for your speed and everything. Huge head unit, seems to be the way everything's going now, which is fine with me. Love the taillights. Taillights are super cool how they're recessed in like a Mustang, but overall, I think it's a pretty cool car. Something new, something different.
So I really like the styling of the new Mustang. I wish they wouldn't call it a Mustang. Like Josh says, I think it should just be called the Mach-E. But one of my two favorite features is obviously the door handle, which isn't even really a handle. You just press the button and it soft opens the door for you. And then as far as interior goes, I like that they don't have any clusters for the dash. It's all just one big screen. And then obviously the iPad for the center console is really cool.
Well, the only thing I've really got to check out of it so far is the exterior, and I'm actually really impressed. You got real sleek headlights, as you can see here. It's a little bit more aggressive than what your typical, I guess if you want to consider this a Mustang would be. A lot of it's very similar to what its, I guess, older brother is. Front fenders look very similar. The rear tail lights and then your headlights have that callback to the Mustang, and even the front hood body lines kind of follow that. The only thing for me is this is an amazing looking car. It definitely has its pluses, especially being electric, and that seems to be what a lot of car companies are going to. But I just don't feel it should be called a Mustang. Beyond that, I think it's pretty beautiful at a price tag of, on the sticker there, it says about $56,000 for the top of the line package, best you can get. I don't think it's bad.
So my first impression was the wheels. I'm really a fan of those wheels. The fact to have the gloss black with the chrome accents, is I'm really a fan of those. The second thing I thought of the Mach-E was the fact that on the inside here, the sound system's actually really good. I doubt you can hear it over YouTube, but this whole cloth looking thing going across the dashboard is actually a speaker, along with the, of course, door speakers here in the door panel. So also a pretty cool feature. The seats are really soft. Again, something you can't see on YouTube, but really good for a road trip, really soft seats that would be comfortable, again, on a long road trip. My least favorite thing about the outside is how you open the door with this button here. It's a cool thought, I guess, but here in Pennsylvania, we get a lot of snow, a lot of ice. So if it's snowing outside, you'll have to brush off all the snow, get off all the ice, it'd be a real pain in the rear end. The back door is even worse. You gotta push the button and there's no little handle here to grab it from the door frame, which again would really suck in the winter time. Besides that, I'm a fan. I'm not really a fan of chrome. There's no chrome on this, which I like a lot. It's basically all white with the black accents. I'm sure there's different trim models, but this one specifically is all white. And overall, I like it.
Overall, I think it's a pretty cool car. It feels very familiar to me. Aside from the touchscreen that obviously is designed to imitate a Tesla, the interior feels like a Ford Escape in some ways, but at the same time, it's a lot different. I love the mini heads-up display that shows you like your battery life and how fast you're going. It's a lot different than just you know, the full gauge cluster and stuff that's normally there. And one of my favorite features, which seems odd, a lot of cars, or even trucks, they're adding in like tailgating features. into the vehicles, whether it's, you know, the Ram bedside boxes, which can be used as coolers, which they talk about all the time. But even up here in the frunk, it looks like there's little cup holders. So an odd feature, it may not even be its design at all, but you could think of it going to the Steeler game or whatever and keep your stuff in here. And I guess this is designed to be rinsed out and drained in some capacity, so you could use it as a cooler if you needed. The rest of the car is really spacious. The cargo area is really big, and when you fold the seats flat, there's a ton of space. So I like that there's lots of room to put stuff in, whether it's groceries or whatever else. I definitely like it a lot more than like a Model Y, for instance, but the one thing I absolutely hate is that they call it a Mustang. It's not. A Mustang's a sports car. This is an electric vehicle. Take that badge off of it, come up with something new, or just call it the Mach-E and call it a day. It's not a Mustang. Other than that, I like it.
I like it. I mean, I don't think it's a bad looking little SUV or crossover, whatever you want to call it. I don't know why they called it a Mustang, because Mustangs are like a performance car. For the looks of the car, I love how it looks. I like how the hood looks. I like how the headlights kind of remind me of an Audi. The rest of the car looks really good, especially with all the gloss black accents. Kind of reminds me of like some of the Jaguars and the Audi Avants that have like the cladding around there that you can get painted, or like a plastic material, like just bare plastic, I guess. The interior of the car I like too. I like the center screen because the Teslas don't have that. They just have the giant screen in the center and that is it. So I guess looking for your speed, it's better to look straight ahead than onto the side. I mean, build quality, I think this is definitely built a lot better than a Tesla. There's not as many imperfections and stuff in the paint as there is in a Tesla. Tesla, you need to work on that because your quality sucks.
Starting on the inside and checking it out, I really like it. I like that there's something here that tells you how fast you're going, other than like the Tesla that has the screen here, just the screen here. But inside, super nice. Radio sounds good. This whole thing is a speaker the whole way across the dash, which is really cool, so I like that. Outside is nice. I like these little buttons. I don't know if this would be a problem though, later on down the road, or in like a snowstorm or something like that. That might be a problem. The outside's cool. I like the wheels. I like the front end. It's a nice sleek look, almost like a Volkswagen or Audi type of front end, but I love the rear end and the taillights. The way they made it look like the Mustang like that. Overall, I think it's a cool car, and I'd get one. It's cool.
So first overall impression, I like it. I think it's nice looking. The shape of it is really nice. I really like the front end. I think the front end is really kind of cute with the headlights and everything. I'm not a big fan of the tail lights though. I think they're kind of weird looking. But I did get a chance to sit in it yesterday, and I know the driver's seat is extremely comfortable, so that was a plus. And the interior is pretty cool. I like the knobs and stuff too, how it's not just like a screen, you know, for the infotainment system and everything. Yeah, I mean, I'm getting a Tesla, and my Tesla can make fart noises. This can't make fart noises, so.
So looking at the side here, there's a four next to this, since I'm assuming it maybe has four electric motors, which with it being a Mustang, hopefully when it leaves car shows now, it can stay under control and maybe not go into crowds as much as the normal one, but time will tell, I guess, on that one.